morning, students. In last lecture, we have discussed about the chemical properties of metals and non-metals with acid and base. Okay, and I have given homework also yesterday. Maybe you completed that homework. So today we will start the next point, that is a displacement reaction. See, if you will read this point, it is there in your textbook. There are the activities which is given in your textbook. That activities we will perform later. So first we will see what is the displacement reaction. See, displacement reaction is one type of reaction. There are the many types of reaction, that is the combination reaction, double displacement reaction, decomposition reactions. Okay, there are the different types of reactions, but in that all types of reaction for your syllabus it is given. The first, that is the displacement reaction. So what it is, a displacement reaction. See, if you will read this name properly, displacement reaction means what? Here in this reaction place exchange. Okay, means displacement means what? The place. See here, displacement means this place is exchange. So the whatever the meaning it is given, according to that only the reaction is. Displacement reaction means place exchange with element. Okay, so in this reaction what happened? See, displacement here definition is given. Displacement reaction is a chemical reaction in which more reactive elements displace a less reactive elements from a salt solution. Okay, so it means properly what is the definition it is given? The more reactive element displace the less reactive element from a salt solution. Okay, got it? So same the meaning what I said before, that to exchange the place, that is only known as a displacement reaction. But who will exchange the place? Those elements. See, in this reaction it is a chemical reaction in which this is very important, more reactive elements. Who will change the place? More reactive elements. This more reactive elements displace means they will take the place of those less reactive elements. Okay, this more reactive elements displace a place of less reactive element from a salt solution. Okay, means for example, CuSO4 means what? Copper sulfate is a salt. Okay, so CuSO4, when it is zinc, when it is reacted with zinc, okay, so what product will form? ZnSO4 plus Cu. Now see, Cu means what? Copper. Okay, SO4 means sulfate group and Zn zinc. So to understand this reaction, this reactivity series is very important. Okay, reactivity series. See, more reactive, K means what? Here just I written the symbols because already you have this reactivity series. Just to refer that reactivity series. Here see, potassium, barium, calcium, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, zinc, iron, nickel. Then what is this? Steel. Okay. Lead, copper, Hg means mercury, Ag means what? Silver, platinum and gold. So this is the reactivity series. These are the more reactive elements and these are the less reactive elements. Okay, so now we will see the place. See here, the first one, what? Cu. Where is the Cu place? See, in this reactivity series, Cu is a downside. Means what? It is a less reactive. Okay, and is another one? Zinc is here. So which one is a more reactive? Zinc is more reactive than Cu. Okay, so this zinc here, the zinc will take place of Cu. So here ZnSO4 and Cu is separated. Understood this example? See, Cu is less reactive than Zn. Okay, so this Zn will take place of Cu sulfate and Cu will be separated. Okay, now see the next examples is ZnSO4 plus Cu. Now here you have to tell me what will be the product. ZnSO4 plus Cu. Now see Zn, where is the place? See Zn and Cu is here. So Cu is able to exchange the place of Zn.
Okay, so today we completed this displacement reaction point.
points. Remaining points we will continue in next lecture. Thank you.